Chuck, we try to make up something incredibly outlandish about the three major cities in our coverage area.
Editor Brian Clary says the outlandish story about Winston-Salem featured some big plans by Mayor Allen Joines.
If you know anybody who's ever come back from Vegas for the first time, they're always like, oh man, you know, I would totally be out there if I didn't have this other thing going on. So we kind of cast him in that role and saying that he wants to maybe bring a little Vegas to downtown Winston-Salem. Like the dancing fountains, the Bellagio.
But mock news stories are not what the paper is known for. So the mayor said initially he feared some would believe it.
Unfortunately, folks read things very quickly, see a headline, read a few quotes in there, and are maybe misled about it. So I think we have to be very careful about that.
I think if you're holding a copy of this paper, you know that this is, you know, this is a joke, man. It's April 1st. It says April Fool's Day all over it.
Once the mayor saw the story alongside other fake news, he played along, issuing his own press release jokingly stating that Yes Weekly was joining his efforts to reduce carbon emissions by ceasing publication, saying the staff unanimously determined that the news value of the publication was not worth the number of trees that are sacrificed to make the paper it is printed on.
Well played, Mayor Joines. You know, I like to see him getting in the spirit of the thing. I knew.